This particular figure is giving us some basic information about the structure of eukaryotic chromosomes. And again, I would remind you that eukaryotes are a type of cell that has a nucleus and has other specific features that we've talked about earlier. That's in contrast to prokaryotic cells, which are said to be bacterial cells. So human cells are eukaryotic, therefore our discussion of eukaryotic chromosomes is very appropriate. So this first portion of the figure is showing us a pair of homologous chromosomes that are unduplicated. This portion where you see sort of a pinching in of the chromosome is referred to as the centromere. And you'll remember from the reading study guide that the centromere does not always have to be metacentric, which is located in the middle. It's possible, for example, for the centromere to be located off-center, which would be submetacentric, or even located at the very ends of the chromosomes, which we referred to as telocentric. The centromere plays a very important role in the separation of chromosomes during cell division, whether it's mitosis or meiosis. So it's important to remember within each one of these unduplicated chromosomes, there is a DNA double helix. And that DNA double helix is made up of nucleotides. And selected portions of that DNA contain important information necessary to build things, and we said those are called genes. We also said genes can have different molecular forms, meaning different A's, T's, G's, and C's that make them up. So in this particular example, an allele or a form of a gene has been represented in this region. So the allele would be in this region on, let's say, dad's chromosome. The corresponding allele would be on this portion of mom's chromosome. Now, we said the two forms don't have to be the same. And so what's being indicated by this uppercase A is this is the dominant form of the allele, meaning that you only need one copy of that allele to be expressed in the phenotype. The lowercase letter is representing the recessive form of the allele. So we could say dad is contributing a dominant allele, mom is contributing a recessive allele. The actual physical position of the alleles on the chromosomes is referred to as the locus. So this is the A locus, and there can be multiple loci, which is the plural form of locus, scattered all over the chromosomes. Now, again, I would remind you, in humans, there are approximately 25,000 genes that are scattered over the chromosomes. Typically, larger chromosomes will have more genes located on them than the smaller chromosomes. The last term mentioned on this particular portion of the figure are the telomeres. And these are the ends of the chromosomes. And telomeres are replicated during DNA synthesis in a very special way. And it's the shortening of these telomeres, or these end regions of the chromosomes, that actually signals the cell that it's time to stop dividing. In other words, to become what the phrase is, quiescent, or non-dividing cell. Now, in some forms of cancer, the telomeres, instead of stopping replication of the telomeres actually continues. Therefore, the cell doesn't get the signal that it's supposed to stop dividing. And that's one of the causes of cancer, or characteristic, I should say, of cancer for cells, is that the telomeres continue to be replicated fully so that they don't shorten. So again, this is a pair of homologous chromosomes. We would have one member of the homologous pair coming from dad, the other member of the homologous pair coming from mom. Now, before the cell can split, either by mitosis or meiosis, the DNA has to replicate or duplicate. So dad's single DNA double helix will replicate, and this produces the structure of a replicated chromosome, and that replicated chromosome, the two portions, are referred to as chromatids. And to show the relationship, in other words, the fact that they're identical, they're said to be sister chromatids. So if dad has the dominant A allele, after DNA duplication, each chromatid will have the dominant allele. If mom has the recessive allele, after DNA replication, each of her chromatids will contain the recessive allele. So later on, we're going to be talking about cell division, and we'll talk about separation of the homologous chromosomes during meiosis. And meiosis is the form of cell division that leads to the production of gametes, which we think of as sperm and egg. And we know that gametes have half the normal amount of DNA in them compared to a regular body cell. So this is going to become a very important discussion later on, again, when we discuss cell division.